Hi, my name is Justin Gash, and I'm an associate professor of mathematics at Franklin College in Franklin, Indiana.
And my name is Andrea Gash, and I work in the annual giving department at the Indiana University Foundation here in Bloomington, Indiana.
Out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you. That every long lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like northern stars, pointing me on my way into your loving arms. This much I know is true, that God bless the broken road that led me straight to you.
I joined eHarmony when I was in Bloomington, Indiana, attending graduate school. It was really hard to meet people that were my age and that were single and didn't have children, actually. So I joined eHarmony in January of 2005 in the hopes of finding my soulmate.
And I joined eHarmony because I was working a lot of hours. I was an executive assistant, and I was living in Fairfield, Illinois. And there just wasn't a lot of people that I was meeting. Everyone that I worked with was married. And so I joined in, let's see, October?
Yeah, it was October. I know it was October.
In October 2005, and just kind of joined and hoped that maybe I would find somebody.
We got matched in late October, so... We joke that it cost me a lot more money to get her than it did her to get me, because I was online since January. And we got matched in late October, went through the process, and here we are.
We actually had a long-distance relationship because Justin was living in Bloomington, Indiana, and I was living in Fairfield, Illinois. And so it was about a 3.5-hour drive, and we only saw each other on weekends. And so it was kind of difficult. We talked every day on the phone, and I wrote to him every Friday. I sent him a little card, and we just really made it work. I mean, on our first date, I knew I would marry him. I knew he was the one, and I knew that I would do whatever it took to make it work.
We actually didn't take us too long to get to that point. We got engaged on March 15th, 2006. I secretly invited my parents. She knew about that, but she didn't know that I was inviting her family as well. We met at a steakhouse that was for a big family dinner. It was sort of in between Fairfield, Illinois, and my hometown of Newburgh, Indiana. And we walked in, and she saw everybody, and I got down on one knee and proposed.
I was shocked. I thought we were just having dinner with his mom and dad. And we went into the restaurant. Justin said, "Hi, we're the Gash. We're here meeting two people." And the waitress was like, "Okay." And, I went up to the room, and there was my dad and my mom and my brother and my sister-in-law and my nephew. And it's just, and his family, his mom, his dad, his grandma. And then before I knew it, he was down on one knee with this beautiful ring. And it was the most magical day of my life.
Yeah, that was a wonderful evening. And
something we will never forget. Yeah. There's been several different hurdles, I would say, in our relationship. We got married on September 16th, 2006, had a beautiful wedding in Fairfield, Illinois. It was everything I had ever dreamed of since I was a little girl. But then I had to move to Bloomington because Justin was finishing up and getting his PhD in mathematics from Indiana University. Moving was hard for me because I had lived with my family in Fairfield, Illinois since I was born. And so moving here to be with Justin was definitely an adjustment. I was leaving my job and my family and my friends. But we got through together and made new friends together. And we have definitely faced it head on. And Justin made it easy for me. And it's great.
It was for you. So, I mean, nothing was going to be too hard for that. I mean... The other thing that's maybe a little more, what you say, unique, or has been my disability. I was born with two skeletal conditions, multiple epiphyseal and metaphyseal dysplasia, and I've had a total of 16 surgeries, most of which occurred when I was younger, but about every 3 or 4 years, I, you know, tack another one on. And so there's been some of that since we've been married, actually. Last December, I had my knee scoped and a bone cyst taken out. And it's been a unique experience, but, I mean, that's what's wonderful about finding your soulmate. Like, in all seriousness, is that whenever I need extra help, someone to push me around in my wheelchair, when I need to use a wheelchair, you know, around the zoo, around amusement park, or just around the mall, you know, she's here. And there's, you know, she does it out of love. There's no extra, you know, price other than she's happy to do it for me because she loves me. So that's been great, but it's been unique, and I'm really, really lucky to have her.
Justin had told me about his disability when we first started communicating with the Harmony, when we had the open end questions section. And he told me that there was times when, you know, he had to use a wheelchair, and that he had had, at that time, 14 surgeries, correct?
14 or 15, yeah.
Yeah.
And it gets a little hazy when you get this higher number.
And, you know, he explained to me that he was, you know, 5 feet tall, and, you know, just some different parts about him, and of course it did not change anything. I loved him instantly, and, you know, I'm always glad to help him when he needs me. And we always get through it together. And for his 16th surgery, it was in December of 2007.
Yep.
And he was really down about it because we were afraid we wouldn't get to go home for Christmas, and he had a bone cyst in his thigh, and isn't that correct?
Yeah.
Yes, and he had a knee scope. And so I had a surprise party for him. I had his brother come down and take him out to dinner, and I had a lot of our friends come over, and they hid, and I had a cake made that actually looked like
the operation
game, which I have in the picture section of this video. And we just wanted to make light of it and show him that I loved him, and we'd get through it together. And
and it was fun. It was a good evening, actually. So I was really surprised. I had no idea. So good job, honey.
Thanks.
So thank you very much, eHarmony, for bringing us together. And we believe that if we need harmony in God, that we were destined to be with one another. And so thank you so much, and I really feel like I have a blessing in my life that I would have never had without eHarmony's help.
We would never have met without eHarmony. Yeah, we were 3.5 hours apart.
Different states, different lives. So, I mean, it was really a blessing. So thank you.
Yes, even if you don't choose our video, we just want to thank you for giving us the opportunity to meet each other and spend our lives together. And I know that we will be together forever. We'd be honored if you did choose us. We would be so excited to show other couples, you know, how it can end up for them. And that you don't have to be lonely, and you don't have to be alone, and you can meet the perfect one.
Yeah. So thank you, and have a good day.